Hello everyone, today we are going to start unit number 1, vector differentiation. So the first, just look at the content of this unit. So first we are going to take the introduction, in that some basic formulas. After that, the concept of directional derivative, the examples depending upon the directional derivative, then divergence and curl of a vector, and the last topic of this unit is vector quantities. So first to start the introductory part of this unit. So first, so what is scalar quantity? So as we know that a physical quantity having only magnitude is called as scalar quantity, and for the vector quantity, a physical quantity having both magnitude and direction is called the vector quantity. So let's take vector a bar is equals to a1 I bar plus a2 j bar plus a3 k bar. So note down here the notation. Here when typing, I use here notation I cap, j cap, k cap, but it is also called as I bar, j bar, k bar. So let us consider the vector a bar is equals to a1 I bar plus a2 j bar plus a3 k bar. Then its magnitude, we can find the magnitude of this vector by using the formula. Magnitude of a bar is equals to under root of a1 square plus a2 square plus a3 square. And its direction can be found by using the formula a cap is equals to a bar upon mod of a bar. Note that for the direction we are using the notation a cap. So next we just define the dot product. So let us suppose that a bar is the vector quantity. A bar is equals to a1 I bar plus a2 j bar plus a3 k bar, and b bar is equals to b1 I bar plus b2 j bar plus b3 k bar. These are the any two vectors. Then we can define a dot product of these two vectors by using the formula a bar dot b bar is equals to a1 b1 plus a2 b2 plus a3 b3. How to get these values, or how to get a value of a bar dot b bar? So if you try to take a dot product of this a bar vector and this b bar vector, so the component wise dot product can be given, that is a1 I bar dot b1 I bar. As we know that I bar dot I bar is 1, so you will get a1 into b1. This is first term. Then when you try to take a dot product of first term of a bar with the second term of b bar, so you will get a1 I bar dot b2 j bar. But here we know that I bar dot j bar, the value is 0. So that term automatically becomes 0. Similar for a1 I bar dot b3 k bar. So value of I bar dot k bar is 0. So that term becomes 0. Then the second term of first vector a2 j bar multiply with the first term of second vector a2 j bar dot b1 I bar. So again j bar dot I bar is 0. So that term becomes 0. Then second term into second term, that is a2 j bar dot b2 j bar. Here j bar dot j bar, value of j bar dot j bar is 1, so you will get the product as a2 into b2, that is the second term. Similar way you will get the last term, that is a3 into b3. So a bar dot b bar is given by a1 b1 plus a2 b2 plus a3 b3. Now the angle between these two vectors, these are the two vector quantities, it has a direction, and we can find the angle between these two vectors. So let theta be the angle between these two vectors, that is a bar is equals to a1 I bar plus a2 j bar plus a3 k bar, and b bar is equals to b1 I bar plus b2 j bar plus b3 k bar. Then that angle theta can be found by using the formula cos theta is equals to a bar dot b bar upon magnitude of a bar into magnitude of b bar, that is a bar dot b bar upon mod of a bar into mod of b bar. Now let us define the cross product of the vector quantities. So cross product, let a bar is the vector quantity, that is a1 I bar plus a2 j bar plus a3 k bar, and b bar is again another vector, b1 I bar plus b2 j bar plus b3 k bar. Then the cross product a bar cross b bar can be defined using the matrix. The first row is I bar, j bar, k bar. Second row is a1, a2, a3, and third row is b1, b2, b3. The determinant of when you calculate the determinant, you will get the value of a bar cross b bar. Now we state here the scalar triple product and vector triple product. So a bar dot in bracket b bar cross c bar, that can be defined as determinant of the first row is a1, a2, a3, second row is b1, b2, b3, and third row is c1, c2, c3. That is same as b bar dot in bracket c bar cross a bar, that is same as c bar dot in bracket a bar cross b bar. And since this determinant doesn't contain any I bar, j bar, k bar, so the solution is a scalar quantity. That's why it is called a scalar triple product. Then vector triple product can be defined, that is a bar cross in bracket b bar cross c bar, can be defined by using the formula a bar dot c bar into b bar minus in bracket b bar dot a bar into c bar. Now keep in mind that here when you define dot product and cross product, so dot product of these two quantities or dot product of two vector quantities is a scalar quantity, and the cross product of two vector quantities is a vector quantity. Now we just see the differentiation of a vector. So let r bar be the vector x I bar plus y j bar plus z k bar. Then when you take a derivative of this vector, that is dr bar by dt, that is nothing but the velocity of that vector or the tangent of the curve. So that velocity or tangent can be calculated dr bar by dt. It is equals to dx by dt I bar plus dy by dt j bar plus dz by dt k bar. Similarly, we can also calculate the acceleration by double differentiation of vector r bar. So acceleration is equals to d square r bar by dt square equals to d square x upon dt square I bar plus d square y bar upon dt square j bar plus d square z bar upon dt square k bar. Similarly, we can also take a derivative of a bar dot b bar, that is equals to a bar dot derivative of b bar with respect to t plus derivative of a bar with respect to t dot b bar. Then derivative with respect to 2 of a bar cross b bar, it is equals to a bar cross derivative of b bar with respect to t plus derivative of a bar with respect to t into our cross product with vector b bar. Then the formula for derivative of scalar triple product, that is d by dt of a bar dot in bracket b bar cross c bar, it is equals to a bar dot b bar cross dc bar upon dt bar plus a bar dot in bracket db bar upon dt cross c bar plus da bar upon dt into bracket b bar cross c bar. These are the derivatives of vector quantities. Then a scalar point function, a scalar quantity phi for its value depends on its position, say x, y, z. Then the function phi of x, y, z is called a scalar point function. And for the vector point function, a vector quantity f bar for its value depends on its position, say x, y, z. Then f bar with function of x, y, z is called vector point function. The collection of all vector point function is called vector field. Now we learn the concept of gradient of a scalar function, that is also called grad phi. So grad phi can be defined as del phi. This notation is called a del. Grad phi is same as del phi. It is equals to the value of del is in this bracket I bar into dy bar dy x plus j bar into dabba by dabba y plus k bar into dabba by dabba z into this phi. Then we can calculate this after simplification. I bar into dabba phi by dabba x, that is derivative of phi with respect to x, plus j bar into derivative of phi with respect to y plus k bar into derivative of phi with respect to z. Then the most important concept, that is the directional derivative. The directional derivative of phi along the direction of vector a bar is given by the formula. Directional derivative, in short we can say dd, is equals to del phi at point x, y, z, the dot product with a cap. So this gives the directional derivative of phi along the vector a bar. The directional derivative is maximum along the normal to the surface and its maximum value is mod of del phi. Then these are the some examples on the concept of differentiation of vector and directional derivative. We will solve this example in the next lecture. Thank you.